Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 41 of the Realm Recap. I'm Jason from YakFace.com. Joined again this week from FlyGuy.net is FlyGuy himself.
Hello, hello.
Hello, sir.
You're cold, and I'm not so cold here, so yeah.
I think I might have to come down and visit or something, because I'm tired of this weather here. Anyway, this week was a little light at first. It looked even lighter more towards the end of the week, but Hasbro decided to release to certain outlets, you know, or access anyway, to images for a bunch of new product that we've seen before, you know, whether it was announced at, you know, Comic-Con or New York Comic-Con. But I think the biggest news of the week starting off was that new 6-inch figures have started to show up at Target. These figures include the Yoda, the Clone Trooper, the green accented one, and the TIE Pilot. And also in that wave is the repack of the Obi-Wan from the prior line look. But it's pretty interesting that these have started to hit already. It just seems like these, you know, the Wave 5, which includes the Sand Trooper, Darth Vader, Luke, and Chewbacca, seem to just be now starting to be found available everywhere. I know some of the Targets that I've been to recently, the figures from the previous Wave, you know, Wave 5, are almost shelf-warming at this point. Like, I saw two Chewbaccas and Luke and Sand Trooper today, and I saw the same figures the day before.
Sure. Well, I mean, they're definitely not out everywhere, that's for sure, even just traveling around the country just a little bit in the last couple of weeks, and people are still hunting for a lot of figures. But yeah, for the nerd crazy geek crazy guys and girls like us, these are brand spanking new. But I mean, they're actually a little bit early. We were planning at Dorksey to get them in, and we are next week. So these are kind of just really well on cue. They're supposed to be December, so they're actually a little early. So it doesn't surprise me. I'd be interested to see whether Target has a street date on them or something, or some kind of date on them, but they are due to arrive, and they were due to be late November, very early December, so they're absolutely bang on cue in terms of time. So yeah, there you go.
What was I going to say? The figures themselves, like you said, they were supposed to be targeted around this time. So
yep,
there's been a little bit of lag as far as shipment from the West Coast. I think a lot of it I think more and more that I read about it, it's having less to do with Hasbro and more to do with a kind of a worker strike thing going on the East or on the West Coast. And I think that's more attributable to why the Rebels stuff took so long to hit retail here as well.
I mean, it's still patchy for a lot of people. I think this is it's kind of annoying expectation, and I see it a lot. Some sites will post, we've got them, and then sometimes it can take another 2 months, for 3 months before it can reach some stores. So there's a kind of expectation of people wanting it yesterday, but it takes months for these things to logistically move. So yeah, they're coming.
And that retail report that we had just talked about for the Wave 6, that happened in Wisconsin, which is it's pretty rare to get a first report for a product that new in the middle of the country versus having it show up on the West Coast. So it's just kind of interesting to see something like that happen.
Well, it's a plus, I think, as well, that and obviously I'm very happy about it as well, is that we're going to get these literally next week in our hands. So they're coming. They're definitely coming thick and fast, and that's great news. But, I mean, we could have been in the same situation as the Rebel stuff, sitting here twiddling the thumbs, waiting for 6-inch till February or something, and it not happening.
Right.
So, you know, we're getting it before Christmas times, which is good, and hopefully some people are going to get them. So I think it's a killer wave. I'm actually really happy about it. I think it's a good wave, but although some people are not happy about it. I've seen a few Yodas have some modifications which look good, because the Yoda does seem a little boggly-eyed. He does seem a little bright of eye, but yeah.
Yeah, I've seen some decent repaints of that of that Yoda and some of the 6-inch Facebook groups that I belong to. So you guys, you said that Dark Side Toys was going to get that late next week, by this time, free shipping, right?
That's right, with free shipping as of next week. So we'll get that. So that gives you an indication of when some people are going to start to get it. So if we start to get initial orders, then if you've pre-ordered it, then you'll begin to get yours. So, but it wouldn't surprise me that stocks will still drip into other places. You know, you're going to be January and February, because we're nearly 30 odd days till Christmas Day. So. Yeah, things are going to be busy. Transport's going to be busy. So if you want them, grab them. That's for sure.
Speaking of some older stuff, actually, we had shared on previous shows that those special value offer vehicle packs that had shown up at, you know, there's like the Ollie's and Kmart, and they originally showed up at Toys R Us. Those have been restocked, apparently, at Kmart. Jesse from Jedi Defender had shared on Twitter the other day that they had shown up at his Kmart again for $9.99, which is crazy for two vehicles from, you know, these aren't the scaled down vehicles that we've received as of late, you know, the past couple of years. These are full size 3 3/4 inch figures or 3 3/4 inch scale vehicles.
It just shows you how, I mean, they've just cut their loss, obviously, Hasbro on these, and just sold these off to discount stores. But $9.99 for these things, so...
And how many did they actually produce in order for these to just still be coming out years later?
And how many more do they still have that they'll drip release to other people? It's
warehouses of these.
Crazy business, the toy business, that's for sure. Anyway, so yeah, if you go to Kmart and find them. $10.
Wow. Kmart, and you know, these include, you know, Clone Wars vehicles and original trilogy vehicles. You know, I guess only two really, the Snowspeeder and the Cloud Car. But there are still a lot of great vehicles in the entire assortment for, you know,
if you can find
gifts
them,
or customizing or just anything. If you passed on them before, I mean, it's essentially $5 a vehicle. You know, when we're paying $6 for a 5-piece figure now.
That's right, yeah.
If you could find them, it's a good deal.
Definitely.
Let's see. Kind of move on here to some images that have shown up online recently. The box has shown up for the Imperial Troop Transport, and that was posted by the website Star Wars Figurine. Showed up in their forums.
Looking good. Looking good. Sadly, the troopers don't really quite fit like that. Aren't they much taller from memory? I think we talked about that in the previous show. So
not quite to scale.
Not quite to scale, And they're not quite as weathered. It's, so it's a shame it's not quite as cool as that picture. But still, there we go. So, and of course,
it's going to be a popular vehicle, I think, mostly with vintage type collectors. But again, it's had a few different appearances in the actual show itself. So,
it's been used quite heavily for one of them. So,
most recently, I can't remember what the episode was, but it's pretty cool.
It's coming.
Let's see what else. Additional Saga Legends and Mission Series packaged images had turned up. Yoda's News received some high-res images of those assortments. And I think most of the figures, if not all of them, look just really pretty good.
Yeah, we're just waiting. There's one there we can have a little look at. Yeah, kind of high-res. That's not a bad-looking look, although he does look very tall, so I'm guessing they've just used the standard. You know, they have it shrunk down a version for look, I don't think, in terms of his height, but that's not a bad layer.
Yeah, I mean,
that's good detail.
If you put things in perspective, these are 5POA figures. They're meant to be inexpensive, easy to produce. They're kind of a throwback design. It's, you know,
yet again,
I'm not going to poo-poo these. I think most people know that I'm pretty much a fan of all of the 5POA figures that have come out as of, you know, the past couple years. So, yeah, I think these are great offerings. And, you know, this is the first time we're getting a Leia. And this is the first time in a long time that we're getting Leia in the A New Hope outfit.
That's right. And again, it's just not a bad figure when you think of the previous, not VOTC she was on, but I think I can't remember the collection, but basically on a vintage card way, way back, maybe 6-7 years ago, there wasn't much more articulation on her. She didn't have that much more then. So that is not a bad layer to have if you haven't got one. So not a bad look either, I have to say. So pretty decent likeness. So yeah. And there were some other ones there in the pack. Still sharing that just now, if you can see it. The new other one, which I hadn't seen before, was the Han Solo, the Bespin outfit. Although that looks like a brand new head sculpt again. It is.
Yeah, the whole figure is new. I talked about this. I jumped on the Wolfpack podcast last night, and we kind of ran down these figures one by one. And yeah, this is again an all new figure.
That's a lot of tooling every time for just this.
Right.
Because we only had one like less than a year ago in the missions. Wasn't the mission pack?
Yeah, there was A New Hope Han that came with the Chewbacca.
That's right.
But yeah, they could have easily recycled, let's say, the legs.
Yeah, exactly.
And put a new torso and arms on it. But no, this is an all new figure, top to bottom.
And it looks like a working holster on this one as well. Just a little.
It does look that way.
Which is kind of cool for a 5POA. So yeah, again, not a bad hand if you don't have one, or you're not too fussed with articulation. It's not too bad. Just again, as we were saying, if this was a vintage card, baby, that thing would shift buckets. But there we go. Anyway.
There's a couple other ones on there. I think, like I said, we had discussed this a little bit yesterday. There's one of the Mission Series packs that hasn't been previously announced and hadn't been talked about before, and that is the one that includes the TIE pilot with the Stormtrooper.
Show that just now.
That one is kind of a surprise.
That's a good army builder pack, that's for sure. So,
you know, we're getting the TIE pilot on an individual card. I think obviously the Stormtrooper has been available in both a previous Mission Series set. It's going to be available in a couple of them, actually. I think he's packed with Hera and
Sabine. That's right. Correct.
He's also available on an individual card, but the TIE pilot is available on a single card here in the next wave or so. So, yeah, this is a new Mission Series one that wasn't announced prior.
It's a great one to get. That's probably the best Rebels Mission Saga Legends wrap it all up figure for me I have seen ever, period. That is a beauty.
Yep.
I think it's just the style and the design. It's also
I'll buy up every one of these that I see.
Yeah, definitely. They are pretty good. They are definitely pretty good. This is also not a bad card. The design of the card is just a lot less hassle. That new card, the black TIE Fighter pilot card, is a pain in the poop. It's the so many dings and little corners, and this one's a little bit more rigid, and certainly the cardboard wedge there keeps it just in much better condition. So, yeah, it's Hasbro. They look great when they design these things, but practically sometimes it can be a little difficult to move them around. So, but yeah, they're great looking figures.
Yep. I don't have this in the show notes here, but I thought I'd touch on it a little bit. Initially, Mission Series figures and some of the other non-figure stuff, like the role-play stuff, and I don't know if it's shown up on the vehicles yet, but most recently I've noticed that the Mission Series sets are shipping as has variant packaging that includes a sticker that has Disney XD logo and a Disney Channel logo on it.
Okay.
I have, let's see, like my original shipments that came, let's say, from Entertainment Earth is one of our sponsors. They had, I had received a case from them. Let's see if I have one handy here. Here is a Darth Sidious with Yoda. Mm-hmm. On the side here, it's blank. It doesn't have a sticker, but later on, of course, I don't have one that has the sticker on it with that a particular pack. Let's say we'll show this one here. This Boba Fett with Stormtrooper Mission Series set. The first one shipped without a sticker. The more recent sticker, and it has the XD, you know, the Star Wars XD, or not Star Wars, Disney XD with the Disney Channel logo on it. And I think a lot of the roleplay lightsabers and some of the 12-inch shampoo bottle figures are starting to ship with those stickers as well.
Okay.
And I think that's a new thing because previously it was solicited that Star Wars Rebels was only going to show on Disney XD. And now it's starting to rerun and rebroadcast on the Disney Channel. So if you, let's say you don't have the Disney XD
In your package.
On your cable package, you can still catch it on the Disney Channel. So I know they air on like Fridays and Saturday mornings. I don't know. It's just a thing I've noticed recently with at least the packaging for the figures. So
I spoke to a scary number of people over the past few weeks that could not get Disney XD.
Yep.
And a lot of them because of their cable package. It's some nonsense about the licenses. They want it and they would pay for it, but they can't get it. So it's just a shame the show's not getting out to a lot more people. Just like the Clone Wars, if they would show it on StarWars.com, at least people in the US would get to see it. But it's infuriating to me why they can't get this out to a wider audience. Just put it behind a paywall and charge people. But
right. I think that's why they're showing it on the Disney Channel, because I think more people get that.
It's a more available channel, yeah.
Right, so anyway, getting back to toys here a little bit. Toys R Us on Thursday had a one-day sale for... They had a discount on the Black Series Endor pack, which includes the you know, the figures themselves, and then an AT-ST, and that was on sale for $69.99, down from $99.99, so you know, $30 discount.
And it's is it worth $70?
I did not me.
No,
not to me. I didn't buy it.
It's just not. It's the AT-ST with the poo-poo feet.
Yep.
A lot of people don't like, and a lot of old figures. It may be a $29.99, I would say, but yeah, I don't think it's going to shift much. That price. That's a shame. Never mind.
Yeah, it was available both in stores and online. I saw they had them marked down on their website as well, so if people wanted it, I think that was their opportunity. I don't know if it's going to go on any lower. I thought it might be available during their Black Friday sale, sure, but I think their ads have now come out for that next week, and it's not featured at all. Very little Star Wars stuff is featured in the Black Friday promotions from any retailer. That doesn't include, you know, I think a lot of the Black Friday sales are geared around the Jack specific stuff and maybe Lego, but not the action figure stuff that we all collect.
Very few stores have them.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's going to be that way.
Let's see. And kind of rounding up the Hasbro news, I don't know if we touched on this last week. I think we might have meant to, but we didn't. Ultimately, there was a reported merger that was going to try to take place between Hasbro and DreamWorks, which, you know, they produce movies like, I think they did Shrek, and then most recently they did the How to Train Your Dragon films. Mm-hmm. Hasbro was in talks to acquire DreamWorks, and they'd be a new entity to produce films and whatnot, and that thing completely fell apart. And I think a lot of it had to do with the fact that Disney, obviously they license a lot of their product or their intellectual material to Hasbro to produce.
That's right.
You know, they Hasbro produces, Star Wars product. They produce Marvel action figures. They're about to start producing Disney princesses and Disney Frozen merchandise. The main thing in that article that we're linking to from the Hollywood Reporter was that Disney got super upset that there was this potential merger to take place. And
I love the quote there, a nuclear level reaction. So
right. It's like it would jeopardize their partnership, saying that, essentially Disney would view Hasbro as a direct competitor to them in their toy production.
Yeah.
And they weren't, I think it also said that Hasbro has essentially 30% of their merchandise is geared around Disney.
Yep.
Intellectual property. Imagine 30% of your product going away because
you
pooped the bed and tried to make this merger happen,
This show's all about poop tonight, but never mind.
Anyway.
This is really surprising how this even kind of got out. I mean, they must have known this was going to cause some problems. It surprises me why this could even get to this level.
This far.
Cause so many shares to plunder and millions of dollars to go south. But, this has to eat into the whole conversations we've been having before. And the rumors are out there, let's face it, about the potential that Disney and Hasbro are not having the best of relations through Rebels and things like that at the moment.
Right.
So, the delay. So, I mean, there's rumors about all this stuff going on already. So,
Yeah, and there was, talk about, Disney buying Hasbro. I mean, it almost seems inevitable, before all this happened, they acquired they both have Hasbro has the Star Wars and Marvel license. They just got the Disney princesses license, from Mattel. It just almost seems inevitable that Hasbro would just, or Disney would incorporate Hasbro at some point. It's like, why pay or why license stuff when you could just keep it all in-house, essentially?
I agree. Well, I mean, you've got Marvel's 9 movies projected and planned, plus God knows how many TV shows and spin-offs.
Right.
Marvel Comics with the whole Star Wars pull in as well. There's merchandising there. And obviously with the Star Wars set of movies to come, maybe TV shows, more Rebels, whatever it may be, there's a lot of toys to come from Hasbro.
Right.
Through Disney. So.
And not even toys, just merchandise in general.
Merchandise in general, yeah. So, wouldn't surprise me if they buy them, but I don't know. That's just going to plunge Mattel into darkness, I think, if they do.
Yeah.
But poor old Mattel.
Let's see.
Interesting stuff, isn't it?
For sure. Moving on, out of the Hasbro news, General Giant this week, they announced a series of pre-orders for some product, the first of which was a Stormtrooper maquette from Star Wars Rebels. This kind of joins the other ones they've announced prior. They had the Zeb, they've got the Ezra with Chopper, and the what's the other? The Inquisitor.
That's right. That's
maquettes. Right. Well, this is the next one.
It's looking good.
Pretty decent. Kind of a generic, not all that action-y of a maquette, but
well, I suppose pending license approval, but yeah, it's. I feel these things, General Giant's obviously they're huge at the 3D scanning and whatnot. So I feel in some ways it's like someone just hey, send me the PSD file for the Stormtrooper. Boom, there you go, and it's like we make one.
Yep.
It seems very simple for them to do, but if maquettes are your thing, 1/8 scale. So yeah, that's pretty big.
Yeah. Let's see. The next one was the a new Jumbo figure was announced. I think this was first shown off at San Diego Comic-Con. They're now taking pre-orders for the Ugnaught figure.
Man, that takes me back.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Started to fray when I was younger in the little vintage part. They started tearing away and always wondering, what is this thing he has got in his handbag here? But little Ugnaught bag. Looking cool, yep. Though. It's, again, if you're going to pay probably the best part of $80-$90, what is the price there? $80. This is a small figure.
Yeah.
So, a somewhat essential one only, I would suggest for some people. But
so this is the blue, is it the blue cape one? You know,
blue cape, indeed.
Blue,
yeah.
Cape, there's the purple variant that's out there that will probably be some sort of future exclusive that'll really piss off a bunch of people.
Yeah, for sure. And there was one more from Gentle Giant as well.
Yes, the Han Solo mini bust. Han Solo is a loose term, I think. This looks nothing like Han Solo to me.
Yeah. This is pretty terrible in my view. He's crossed arms and the metal. What?
I'm going to screen share something here quick.
You just take mine off.
See.
It's a very meta figure to have. Han Solo, yes. Han Solo with Yavin metal?
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever. It's.
Let's see, where are you here? Okay, I'm sharing a Photoshop thing I've been screwing around. It's not like I didn't have anything else to work on today or do, but so here's this Han Solo that they advertised. I don't know if everyone can see it.
Yep,
I hope you can.
Yep.
So I'm looking at this figure or this mini bust, and it's like there's nothing here that seems to be Han Solo to me.
It's like a bored guy just waiting for a bus or something.
Right, so okay, let's take that off. So we'll remove the Han Solo portion of the copy there. And then I added a mustache. It's Movember, you know, it's no shave November. Who does that look like to you?
Tom Selleck.
Okay, so we'll put this little tag down here, Glenn Larson Productions. So then we'll throw this other layer on. Oh, there's a Hawaiian.
Oh, shirt. It is!
And then there's, oh, this is the Thomas Magnum figure. Oh, no, wait, it's Magnum P.I.
I was right. Oh, fantastic. And, of course, he nearly did play the part of Han Solo, but there you go. So
I think he was supposed to be Indiana Jones.
Oh, Indiana Jones, so it was, my bad.
That figure that minibus to me screams
Magnum P.I. Magnum P.I., it does. Which, by the way, kids, if you have no idea what we're talking about, is an old TV show from Jason and I's childhood. So
yeah, from the 80s.
Teenhood. So
PC and, you know.
Do you know, maybe this is what they're doing, Jason. They're basically just making this basic kind of mold or template, and then they just start coming up with classic 80s. Classic 80s busts for TV shows. That. That was very good.
That was my afternoon. Show. What did you do?
I didn't do that. I was working. Never mind. The things you do when you're bored.
I know. I had an itch. I had to scratch.
I'm glad I was right for the Magnum side of things. So anyway, so yes, so Han Solo of Yavin. Han Solo, hero of Yavin.
So that's a $90 minibus that looks nothing like Han Solo. So spend your money accordingly.
Please let us know. Write in, leave a comment if you are buying it. We'd love to know.
Let's see. What else? Sideshow this week, they released a pretty entertaining commercial kind of thing for their speeder bike that's kind of in the vein of an Apple.
Which was it Apple? I thought it was more like just a generic card ad. But maybe I'm wrong.
You're right. It seems very John Ivy.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. I like that with the little tripper moving them back and forth there. Thunderbird style puppets. So yeah, hopefully if you're watching the video version of the Rim Recap, then this biker scout talks over this purchase that he's made of the speeder bike. But it's nicely done, isn't it? They've really done a great job in some of the recent videos. The 3PO one was really well done, I thought.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, just accenting and highlighting how ridiculously awesome this thing is and how much I want it, but I just can't pay $300 for it. It's just Yeah. Just can't
It's
part
a
with it,
pretty
I'm
cool
afraid.
piece, though.
It is a beautiful
They
piece.
do a, it's a very entertaining video. You know, we have the link in our show notes. Give it a watch. It's very Apple commercial like. See, cool. Also from them this week was the C-3PO went up for pre-order on Thursday. They revealed some additional images and announced the exclusive for that, and it has the battle damaged, you know, Tusken damaged
Tusken
arm.
Raider, yeah, Tusken,
yeah, from A New Hope.
The photos were looking a little bit better, I think, than when we saw the preview post mm-hmm. we were talking last week. The face, that's just not looking great there. But, forget that for two. So I'm just being really picky. It's a beautiful looking figure overall. They've absolutely nailed it on the gold.
Yeah.
Nailed it. And even the weathering as well. So that's much more 3PO like there. I think it's just the poses sometimes in the photographs. It can be problematic, but...
Yeah, it has that brushed gold aluminum look that that really sells it, I think.
It really does. There's a high kind of res close-up there of 3PO's waist, and the articulation in the fingers as well is a very Hot Toys Iron Man thing, and I'm sure on the bottom of that box Hot Toys has been involved in some capacity. But there we go. That's much better. That looks like 3PO's face bang on the money. So I don't know what it is. Maybe just sometimes... some photographs, but it's a beautiful piece. So 229, I think. Who was closer? I can't remember. I think you said 179, didn't you? No.
I think my guess was.
Or was yours over
240? 240, maybe. I'd have to look, but this is, you know.
That's not bad. That's not bad.
It's about par for the course for recent releases from Sideshow.
And for such a detailed figure with internal lights, and I wouldn't expect it to be any less, actually. It's a pretty good price for what it is. Pretty classic stuff.
Yep. Let's see. A couple other products this week was the Herocross Hybrid Metal Configuration Boba Fett.
That's right.
They have other figures in this line. There's, you know, there are various stormtroopers, both white and black.
Black, that's right. Vader.
Darth Vader.
I think this is the fourth overall, so I should be getting one of these, hopefully. So I'll give you a little look once we get it
cool.
In future. But it's a pretty neat piece. Did you ever have any of these Herocross figures?
No.
The stormtrooper was really solid. He's a very stylized, cool look there, which kind of reminded me of the kind of Medicom. Do you remember the Medicom Kubrick style of kind of, not Kubrick, but the Medicom had a kind of chunky, funky style a way, way back.
Yeah, what were those called?
I can't remember.
I have the Yoda.
Yes, that's right. They brought out a trooper at one point as well, which they milked to death.
Yep.
And had the Stormtrooper, the Clone Trooper, the 501st Clone Trooper. And that style of figure is very much what it's like. But these are pretty solid and in parts metal, I think metal joints.
Yeah, I think that's the point of them. The
heavy,
hybrid metal configuration.
Exactly. No, of course. But
Some switch out parts, you know.
He looks cool. Do like him. Yeah, very neat. Articulated on the legs and was a cool looking little guy.
And this is based on his look from Return of the Jedi versus Empire Strikes Back.
But looking forward to get that. I really like that, actually. Very cool. Nice and stylized.
Yep. Let's see. Cool. Some new images popped up this week on Facebook for the Samurai Vader and Stormtrooper figures. Yep. I thought those look pretty cool.
They do. Oops. I've just clicked back there. Let's go back to that picture. They do look pretty cool.
Yeah, these images were shared by Sith Fire 30 Creations.
Yep.
Probably popular customizer, but...
Yes, indeed. Yep, looking good. What do you think? Are you going to pick one up yourself? Or are you kind of
I do really... like them. The more and more I see them, the...
I know, the more I see the Darth looks particularly strong.
It's almost like the... especially with the Stormtrooper, it's almost like the armor is carved out of bone.
Yeah,
it makes ivory. It just has that ivory look to it. I think that's really, really cool to pick up a couple of them to flank the Vader.
Yeah. I was going to see what we can do in ivory hunting, but never mind.
And then there were a couple model kits that have shown up online. These were revealed, again, we had talked about them on a prior show, but these links here show just how complex the model kits are for the Bandai Vader, TIE Fighter, X-Wing.
Are we talking X-Wing at the moment? Sorry, I'm on the...
No, we could stick with the Vader, and these are just different links I've shared from the same site.
Sure. So, this is the articulated cape version, and this makes so much more sense in this photograph now. The whole snap-out, kind of snap-and-fix style stuff, that makes much more sense. But that's kind of cool, actually. That's quite good fun.
Yeah, I mean, just... all of the parts, you know, you see these, these part trees here, and all of these parts are going to make a articulated action figure. It's kind of hard to believe, you know. The only thing I don't quite understand is the two sticker sheets that they show there. It's like, I don't get the purpose of the two different ones.
That's a good point.
I don't know. Someone might have to explain to me. I might have to talk to Rich a lot from over at Pop Critica. That he knows a lot about these kind of foreign type of figures. But yeah.
Well, that I think that what we're looking at there is that's the the print around the sticker so that when you peel it out, you're not getting white on the label. I think that's the actual stickers peeled off and put on a separate sheet.
Oh, really?
I'm circling around here. That's the bounding box around that.
Uh-huh.
And then you...
Huh. Oh, maybe that is.
Do you know what I mean?
If you were to peel off the border.
Exactly.
But why is the sticker, why is the sheet smaller then?
It's not that it's really smaller, I guess. Well, maybe a smaller piece of paper, but it's got less on it. Yeah, you're right. I'm guessing it's just, but this one has this big, thick bounding around everything, whereas you can see it's just not present there, which seems odd.
It's weird. But,
this is probably an instruction sheet, maybe. No? Oh, who knows? Complete guessing, but.
It's pretty amazing how many little parts there are into building this figure.
And we should look at the other ones as well. There's the TIE Advanced. Obviously a lot less parts, but
still complex.
Yeah. But actually good fun as well. I mean, little mini Vader as well. Sitting Vader, standing Vader.
Yeah. Lasers.
Lasers, green lasers, right. I get it. There's the sticker sheet thing again going on. Maybe it's instructions and I don't know. But it looks more complex than it actually is once you see these parts. And the final one there was the X-Wing.
Yep.
And so I guess you've got to paint these things, really.
Yep, these are unpainted. I think when we shared this, some of these links prior, when there was the Bandai show, it seemed to convey that they were pre-painted. At least that's how I understood it. But no, these are not pre-painted. These are, cast pieces, and you kind of snap, fit them together.
Yep. And spend probably the best part of half a day putting all these stickers on. That's insane.
Yeah.
Well, I guess you probably don't need to paint it if the body is done in the right color, so you're just adding these stickers to the... you could probably get away with it, actually, because the body is in the right color. The parts in the red are in the color, so
Some of the torpedoes are cast in the right color, and some of the stripes along the side of the body are cast in that red plastic. But it's pretty, a pretty intense kit.
It is indeed. I didn't see a little Rebel figure there, but it seems to mention there's one on the box, a little
Yeah, there's a rebel figure, and there's a astromech. Two different styles you can put together, an R2 or an R5.
Yeah, it's just because he's painted in the other examples. So you're right, there's definitely lots of elements to be painted. So they're fun kits. They look definitely something different for the Star Wars license. I haven't seen any of them in a long, long time. So very cool.
Yep. Again, we'll share these links in the show notes for the show, and you could take take those links to check out the individual images and scope those parts out for yourself. Let's see. Wrapping up a little bit here on this stuff was that Brandon Flores, who has produced the custom AT-ST Walker and the custom AT-AT, has apparently all the time in the world and has started to produce the 6-inch scale Snowspeeder to go along with it.
That's just insane.
It's nuts. I mean, I think I've shared about 30 photos in this gallery. He's well beyond what I've shared here. He's got the engines done. He's got the weapons done. He's added
lights,
you know, fiber optic lights for the cannons. It's just insane. And this has taken him a matter of days.
How is this guy doing this? This is amazing work. And there you go, your 6-inch.
Yeah, this is, wow. Again, 6-inch scale. So,
well, what it does show us is, I mean, that's not out of reach for a retail shelf for a 6-inch line figure, really. I mean, you could, I mean, that's, you can get that at maybe under $100 for that. That's, so it's not out of reach to see vehicles in the 6-inch line. We know that some are coming at some point. But how did he get all this?
Yeah, this is, it's just all kit-bashed, assembled, greebleed
parts from everywhere.
Parts, yeah, just like how ILM would have done it back in the day, you know?
Wow. That's pretty impressive stuff. With lights on the thing. Man. So we just need a deck figure. Good luck for that one, if guys.
Yeah, I'm sure I'll make one. He's already made a Snowspeeder Luke version, you know, because we only have the X-Wing Luke.
So has he tweaked the...
He's added the collar, puffed it up, you know.
Wow. Some work, customizers, hats off again. Amazing, amazing stuff. It's pretty detailed, that's for sure. So...
Yeah, it's very cool.
Excellent.
Let's see. Cool. Moving on to the next section of the week is the Toy Guide updates and review portion. I'm kind of falling behind what I said I was going to do last week. I thought I would be into the more into the mission series that I haven't done yet, but I did manage to knock out the official review and Toy Guide update for Jango Fett and the Clone Trooper for this week. I have some of the other figures done. I just haven't uploaded the guides and images yet, but
so we were talking about this last week, but still, I mean, if you haven't seen them, great looking kind of detail in these photographs. This, again, as I said last week, this is a really impressive Jango Fett. It really is pretty damn good. And again, it's just once you see the high res quality, you've taken this from every single angle, which really lets you see and decide if you want to buy this thing or not. So impressive. It looks good. Looks good. So you, that was the only one I think we had, wasn't it? Do we have any more there?
Yeah, I did the Clone Trooper as well.
So you did, my bad.
Let's which is a repack of the Clone Trooper from the Darth Vader lava line look.
Ah, okay. Oh, for some reason, it's just the links there. Let's have a look. Let's just go straight to your Toy Guide. And we'll get the link that way. So... Where are we? Saga Legends. And Clone Trooper. Oh, Chopper. I've never even looked at your Chopper images. Excellent. I have to see that. That's not a bad looking clone. He looks pretty solid.
Yeah, it's not terrible. It's
well proportioned.
Not again, terrible, if you bought the first version, this is just a repack with a slight paint variant with only because it has the date stamp on the back of the legs.
Of the legs.
But
no, that's yeah, he's pretty good. He's pretty. Looks great with the Jango. Does look good that way. Good job. So that's a lot of work to take all these photographs. A lot of time to get this and upload it.
Try to squeeze those into my day.
Don't know how you do it, but it's no, that's pretty good. Lots of detail as well on all the figures. Love this stuff. Yep, date stamp in the back. That's it. So same figure. So army builder.
Yep. Let's see.
What's next?
Moving on to TV, movie, book, and game news. Obviously, people that have been following the Star Wars Rebels show know that there's going to be the conclusion of the two-part arc that has happened last week and which concludes on this coming Monday. After that, there's going to be a holiday break for the series, and that's going to resume then after Christmas, even after New Year's, even, and it will resume on January 5th with new episodes.
What did you think of the episode?
I thought they were both good.
I'm presuming you watched the the new episode. Yeah, they're pretty good. Pretty good.
Pretty decent. Cool. You get even more of Ezra's backstory, and
that's right.
Kind of, you know, the first part ends on a cliffhanger, and you kind of move on to the next one. So, yeah, it's good. The series is very solid so far. You know, the first season has been only slated for 13 episodes, I believe,
mm-hmm.
which is
that's right.
Missing words.
You know, if you use the Clone Wars as an example, I think most of those were, 20 plus episodes for their series. So,
I liked how we've in some ways got a little bit of an insight into Lobot. I was talking about on my blog last week, because I mean, obviously Sibo here is wearing the exact same headgear, and nice little touch there, I guess, to mention that it was it's an Imperial piece of headgear at the wraparound. But I mean, it's clearly Lobot inspired. So,
so has Lobot been a slave?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, I think whether and maybe. Maybe that's some story we'll see one day. Who knows? But maybe Lando's converted and whatever. But interesting stuff.
Let's see. There have been rumors of the Force Awakens teaser trailer is supposed. It's hard to know what to believe anymore. You know, it's like there are so many different rumors that come out. You know, they say it's going to be attached to the Hunger Games. You know, Mockingjay Part 1. Then they say, oh, no, it's going to be attached to the next Lord of the Rings, the Hobbit movies. And then they now say it's going to be attached to every movie under the sun that they use. 100 theaters next weekend. It's hard to know what to believe, but
I kinda
definitely
imagine
it's coming out sometime soon.
If they're going to put this thing in cinemas only, that's kind of nuts. You would put this thing online for maximum exposure, PR.
And that's what's been bandied about, is that they're going to give the widest possible reach that you can. You know, being Disney, they're going to put this in theaters. They're going to put this for download. They're going to put this on, you know, websites, YouTube, any place you could possibly watch it. It's going to show up. But I think it's going to show up sooner rather than later. It just, everything is just kind of hinting at that pattern. And most recently, I think both you and I had saw earlier today that there's this GIF image that's been floating about showing maybe a clip from the trailer of the Millennium Falcon. It's not spoilerish in any way, so if people are very sensitive to that, it doesn't spoil anything.
So we're sharing it right now, but it's if you're watching the video version, you're seeing the Falcon flying towards just... I mean, this could be... I can remember when the Clone Wars was coming out, we saw what we thought was a sneak peek of it, and someone had done hours worth of what must have been time and energy spent into creating an almost like a trailer with Boba Fett and TIE Fighter pilots, all fake. So, for someone to do this in 3D Max or Maya or some other kind of digital tool, who knows?
You know, there's there's lens flare in there. I mean, that's it's a very obviously a J.J. Abrams kind of thing, which makes me think it's fake, because if you're going to show a clip like this and throw a lens flare in there, it's just, it almost seems like it's a poke at Abrams' style.
And what is that in the background?
The blue?
Yeah.
Those are, that's a lens flare. On both sides of the Falcon, to the left and the right.
It looks like more the side of a Star Destroyer or something to me. It just looks weird. That doesn't.
It's hard to say. And the shot, it's like personal, you know, computing technology has come so far in the past, you know, five to whatever years. It's like someone could create this at home, essentially. You know, this very well may be a fake clip.
Sure.
But they did manage
a lot of them before 7, isn't it?
Yeah. They did manage to get some new details right as far as the Millennium Falcon does have the proper new rectangular radar dish that's on there, and I don't know. It just seems either way, it could be fake, it could be real. It looks decent either way. I don't care if it's either one or not. It's very Attack of the Clone-ish.
Yes, so
it's the slave, you know, the Slave One coming up the screen like it did, you know, through the asteroid field.
Absolutely.
So.
Yeah, which is a little odd, but who knows? There's going to be a lot of stuff coming up before we get to the release of this movie, but something's coming soon. That's pretty much the strongest rumor, which would make sense. At this point, but that's a year out.
Yeah.
It's a long time. So.
Yeah, so if you're interested in seeing more kind of spoiler stuff like this, and even some heavier spoilers, visit makingstarwars.net. They have a lot of the great first revealed rumors and stuff around The Force Awakens, so you can check that out there. Let's see. Celebration Anaheim. There was a new StarWars.com had released for the upcoming Celebration, which, you know, kind of cuts in old footage from prior shows. But they're starting to hype that up pretty big. You know, it's only a few months away, actually.
It really is. It's that's the hall at Essen, Germany from last year, and in fact, I may be in there. So, but I was there. But it was that was a big hall, and that's from other celebrations. There you go, Celebration 5 in Florida, Warwick Davis, and all the R2 droids. But it's past footage, basically, all put together to just create that kind of buzz. It's from Essen, Germany. So,
around the 42nd mark, there's a shot of a guy wearing the Star Wars, or the Yak Face Star Wars Action News shirt from our party that year.
There we go.
There it is.
Yak Face Star Wars Action News, a couple of great sites.
With Daniel Boba Fett himself.
Amy Allen and the Three Fets. So, like we know we're going to probably get this the same kind of thing. There'll be a main hall. We're going to get celebrities and guests. We're going to get cosplay by the bucket load, vendors and merchants, and great panels. It's going to be a pretty big show. I think just because it's everyone knows there's a movie coming out as well. It just
It's going to be intense.
Intense is the word. That's very very cool. So. Already a lot of things listed and coming up for it, so yeah.
Yeah, you had shared a list earlier today, artist list of people to be in attendance there and offering some of their works.
Yeah,
pretty,
there's been
a pretty substantial list. I think you had mentioned on Twitter that there was a name missing off there.
Yes, there was. So Jake, creator of this logo up here, and friend of mine for many years, and someone who's been at every celebration I've went to anyway, just was sadly not on this list. So there's still a lot of artists there, some great people, some familiar faces. Jay Vandersteel's there, Cat Stags, some real, you know, been there all the time. Matt Bush, you know, you've seen a lot of these people. Katie Cook, a lot of these people have been at celebrations before, but just a little gutted. Dave Dorman is not there. I mean, come on, if you know Dave Dorman's stuff, if you don't Google the guy, stunning guy, and Jake as well, just a completely different style of art. So who knows? The Star Wars team and Mary Franklin, the guys, mentioned that they really, you know, it was a tough decision and they had to weed some people out and change things up a little bit. So, but yeah, it's going to be a big show. I'm really, I've got to see, I can't wait to see what the exclusive will be for this, the Hasbro exclusive. It's got to be something pretty big, I hope. So, so between that and the artist, which is always good fun, it's going to be a good show. Call me a good show.
Yes. Speaking of Celebration again, I saw this article or news shared over at Rebel Scum. There's word of delay for the pins that have been solicited. You know, there's different pin sets that have come out based on Christopher Lee's artwork that was purchased by Lucasfilm. I think these are delayed a couple months. Mm.
You will receive them well before you arrive at Celebration, so right. It's just a little bit delayed. So January 2015, I mean, that's hardly, you know, it's weeks away, a matter of weeks away.
Yeah, and they've pushed other solicitations out, so you're not going to miss out on anything if you're looking to, you know, stay current on these sets. But as a make good for the delay, they're offering up this exclusive Anakin Skywalker pin, which is pretty cool.
Oh dear, very, very good. Yeah. So yes, Road to Celebration is beginning.
Yeah, it's cool for them to recognize that there's a problem with, you know, fulfilling these orders, you know, this far out, and they want to make sure that everyone gets them and everyone's able to order. And as a, you know, quote unquote apology for the delay, they're still able to release something else.
Yep.
You know, to go alongside. So there's a lot of people that collect, you know, pins and buttons and that kind of kind of thing. You know, there was a whole room I think dedicated to trading and whatnot. That's at different celebrations. So
still worried about this whole pin collecting thing. The that you have to, as we mentioned before, find some people to get a pin off them. It's going to be tough, I think. But I guess that's what the hunt is they want. They want to get people to do that. So a lot of pin trading will be going on, that's for sure.
Right.
And the last one.
Last one on this was just a couple days ago, even though it's probably been announced prior, StarWars.com posted a trailer for a new Lego Star Wars series, or at least episode that's going to premiere on the Disney XD channel tomorrow. This is another one in the series of the new Yoda Chronicles. This one's called Clash of the Skywalkers.
I have to say the voice for this is particularly good for Luke, I think.
I thought so as well. It's like, is that Mark Hamill? It's like, yeah, it's not Mark Hamill.
But it's particularly well done. So Clash of the Skywalkers. So it seems to be less about Yoda and more about Luke and Darth here. So
good fun. Again, like the Star Wars Rebels series, if you are a Disney XD subscriber, you could already watch it on their Watch Disney app, whatever it is, app or online. You don't necessarily need the app, but I haven't watched it yet, but it'll give me something to do tomorrow, I guess.
Okay.
There you go.
Volume, yep.
You're back.
Okay.
So, let's see. That moves us to new toy acquisitions and purchases this week. Me was very light, but I did score a few things. I shared it on Facebook. I think it was yesterday or the day before. I'm trying to find it now. I picked up this Error of the Boba Fett with Stormtrooper, and
that.
my Boba Fett has missing paint apps. He doesn't have a painted belt. It's just white or very light gray plastic.
It's rare.
Yeah, it is very rare. And what's weird about it too is you could see how these figures are painted prior to assembly, because if you were to look at the back of this figure, the belt is painted on the back of the figure.
Oh, really?
But not on the front half, you know, where the seam would split, you know, through the torso. So, yeah, both the belt and his Wookiee braids are not painted with the brown as they should be.
Excellent.
So I thought that was pretty unique, so I picked it up for $10.
Excellent.
Come on. You don't run into that weird stuff every day, so I grabbed that. Let's see, what else did I get? I received a book via Lucasfilm. They sent me a copy of the Tarkin novel by James Luceno.
There's a good audiobook version of that out as well, actually.
I know. I want to get the audio version because I have absolutely zero time to actually read a book. But I did read the first chapter today, and it's pretty good. I mean,
yeah.
To be honest, I don't have a whole lot of benchmarks to weigh it against, but it's a decent read. I like it.
So Stephen Stanton read a while ago, and I think, is he reading the audio version? I don't think he is.
I don't recall.
I don't recall, but he certainly read a chapter, and it just had a nicer ring to it. I think he just does a great job at being Tarkin. So
let's see what else. And then I picked up the non-Star Wars related. I went to my local Toys R Us today because they had the Lego poly bag of Rocket Raccoon.
Snap. He's pretty cool, isn't he? I love
very cool. I like him.
The sticker sheet, Arnie and I were talking about it this morning on.
I saw that.
Yeah, we were. So basically, to confirm about it, it's a set. The stickers inside it, if people don't know what it is this is a set of battle damage stickers which go on the Milano space. Yeah, okay. So you and I now know it, but I must admit, this morning I was kind of like, what is this? But
I wasn't sure either. It's like, these stickers go on the figure, or they go, you know, I'm looking up, you know, the Rocket's vehicle. It's like, oh, did these go with that? Or it's very cool. They kind of tie that into another Lego set. I don't know if that's ever really happened before.
That's what I was saying this morning. I've never seen them do this before. I mean, it's a whole sticker sheet. Pretty good little stickers that's even got, instead of Awesome Mix Volume 1, it says Awesome Tape Number 1 and Awesome Tape Number 2, which is movie accurate. It gets the two tapes in the movie. So really, really nice touch.
Get the Nova. I haven't seen the movie yet.
Wait, what?
Nope.
You're kidding me.
With all my time, I've not seen it.
With all your time. Stop doing Magnum PI things in the afternoon.
Yeah.
To see cartoons.
I'll buy it on iTunes or whatever here, so
Blu-ray
I can
or something.
I wish it, to be honest, I really wish I would have seen it in the theater just to get that whole experience. But
this was the San Diego Comic Con Rocket. So if you I feel it saying, "Can I do a Nelson Munch from The Simpsons?" And if you spent a lot of money this at San Diego, you actually got it in a very nice box and a different presentation. But it's the same Rocket, so.
To tie it back to Star Wars a little bit, they did the same thing with that prototype Boba Fett a couple years back.
That's right.
They offered that at, it must have been San Diego Comic Con, and then they offered it as a poly bag later.
That's right. Yes, and people still want about $30 for that thing.
I sold mine for a lot more than that.
Oh, there you go. So that was me as well this week. I just get exactly the same thing as you, and a couple bit more. Fake Lego, as Scott from Tulsa calls it. So, Flego.
Flego, yeah.
Which I love. Copyright Scott from Tulsa, but a little Silver Surfer and other stuff. So, yeah, no Star Wars this week. Nope, not a bean. So,
nope.
I did get all the 3.75 Black Series Wave, which I'll review. We've talked about in the show already, the Starkiller Malgus and R5 and the Luke Skywalker Hoth is Wampa Attacks. It's the absolute gem of the pack.
Mm-hmm.
And a little tip to anyone out there, if you're watching this and you haven't got those figures yet, for goodness sake, go online and get them. Of course, they're available at DarkSideToys.com, but definitely, while Starkiller and Margus are popular, the Luke Skywalker and the R5 droid are hugely popular.
Yep.
So, obviously, never been out before, the slightly tweaked version, so don't delay on those ones, because the previous waves, such as Reese and Skiff Guards, are just insane amounts of money for those things. So, so pick them up.
Sounds good. I think with that, that wraps up this week's show. Again, as always, I'd like to thank everyone for watching and sharing and commenting on our past shows. We will be back maybe next week. This is a holiday weekend coming up. We'll, you know, work things out here in the next couple days. But we hope to be back next week with a new show and new info to give everyone. So, again, thanks for watching, and thanks again to Fly Guy for joining us this week.
No worries, and happy Thanksgiving when it comes around, people.
Have a good one, everyone.